it was wonderful when they put when they moved the library down here right across the street from us.
Mm-hmm.
And my children were kind of raised in the library, and went to all the we've gone to all the events and everything. It's so easy for us just to walk across the street and go to the library, and it's one of the best libraries in the country, I'm mm-hmm. given to understand. And everywhere I go, anywhere in this nation, if you mention the Port Washington Library to people who know libraries, it's well known, and right. it's respected. So we feel tremendously lucky that
mm. live how here. How did you happen to join the Music Advisory Committee?
Well, Ruth Feingolden was the one who invited me several years ago. I don't know how many years ago now. She said that they had many connections with chamber music and with classical music and jazz and all that, but they had no real connection with folk music. So mm-hmm. they needed a folk person to come, and that they wanted to present good folk concerts. And so that's my position on the council, is that I advise and help them find folk talent.
In deciding to recommend an individual or a group in folk music to the committee, what are you looking for in doing that?
Well, we have very high standards. I know that Jackie and Ruth and all the other members, that's one of the things that we agonize over, is in making our selections. At first, it was, you know, we were out there looking and reaching and looking for people. Now we have to turn people away because everybody wants to perform there. It's become a status thing, or word gets around that it's a very good place to perform. And so the problem is now choosing among all the people who send us tapes and mm-hmm. who want to play there. So we really like to present very high caliber music. So among the folk musicians, I look for the same thing. I look for people who represent sort of the top of whatever phase of folk music they do.
You yourself have performed from time to time in the library. How has that come about in terms of the Music Advisory Committee?
My first performance at the library was when my children were, I think I had both children at the time. We were living here. We moved here in 57. And so that was my first performance, was when it was up on Bellevue, mm-hmm. the little dwelling house up there. And we performed up there as a family. We did family songs, and they were just two little, me and my two children. And over the years since then, I've done, I guess, maybe three or four more performances for them. Every once in a while, they invite me to sing. Being a member of the music committee, I held off for years and said, no, it's a conflict of interest. I won't do it. And finally, Ruth and Jackie and all the others got after me one year and said, you've got to do this now. This was, I guess, the decade celebration year, you know, the time that the library was 10 years
yes,
old.
Yes, yes, 1970.
And, yeah, so I did a
70,
I did a
pro- 1980.
I did a program then, and now they say it's the centennial, so I have to do another one.
You've been associated with the library for many years, and you mentioned earlier your son's going to the library and you're taking mm-hmm. them there for programs. What meaning has the library had to you besides your work on the advisory committee?
Well, it's very hard to say how much the library does mean, because it is so much a part of our lives. It's like the folk music back home when I grew up. It was like churning and breathing and walk in and things like that. The library seems that way to me now. It's, I guess I'd miss it the most if it were suddenly gone. We take it for granted an awful lot because it's so near and it's so easy to use, and people are so friendly. But it's meant it's meant, well, it's a very important part of our lives. It's meant social things, it's meant stories and parties, and there's my picture I won at the...
Yes.
I won the costume prize over there.
The costume
That's
ball.
Very funny. So the library is meant a big, important part of our social life and our learning. My boys have used it for their schoolwork and for... and I've used it for my reading of material, and George has used it for his reading and then for his... Also the sound, the video part.
Mm-hmm.
He works for the library. He's done programs, many programs for them. So we've been employed by the library.
Mm-hmm.
I've been employed by the library, so it's been a source of employment and enjoyment, I guess you could say.
Has the library been a resource place for you in terms of your own work?
Yes, it has. I've looked up many things over there for in folk music, and I haven't written anything. I am a writer, but I've not written anything in a very long time. But when I was writing, I did use the library quite a bit for that.
Mm-hmm. Looking into the future with the projected expansion of the library, what role do you see for the Music Advisory Committee and folk music as part of its program?
Well, I think we'll go on the way we've been going on, and we'll try to keep our standards ever high, and we'll try to bring the best music that we can to the library and to the people of the community and to the people who use the library. You know, we have many people who use the library who live far away.
Mm-hmm.
They come, especially the music committee knows about them because they come to the concerts, and they live in Flushing, and they live in New York City, and they live in many places further out on the island, and they come to the concerts, and they contribute money to run the programs, and so we feel that our library is not only for Port Washington, but it's really for the whole region.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the music committee is concerned, we serve a very far-flung region, so that's exciting too.